go and tell God, you told us that in this temple, anytime we come, the day we open this church, you are man of God, Pastor Akson. You are woman of God, Pastor Elizabeth. You are man of God, Pastor Alfred. You are woman of God, Pastor Lucy. They stood on this altar, and this is what they said. Any prayer which will ever be made on this altar, heaven will be here. And now we are coming to the King. Am I talking to somebody? Tusimaliziane inje, twende kwa King. King will decide who is who. Let me tell you, sometimes what your mouth will not give you, your knees will give them to you. What your mouth will not give you, your knees will give them to you. I say what your mouth will not release, your knees. Someone say my knees. Oh my goodness. When I find that I have spoken a lot and nothing is coming, I stop talking. I go like this. I pray. I talk to the King. And what will tell you that the King is answering is when the King will send you back to this. When the King tells you, I know the plans I have for you, not evil ones, but good ones, to give you future and to prosper you. Then you know the King is acting. When they went to the King, wakabeba wote wawili. Huyu mwenye amepewa kipek, na amesha confirm ni kipek. Na haka kengine kenye, kanajua kama, kalipeana pek. Kwanza sasa kakibibaga huku toi, kakibaga na mwangalia. You know the affection. So the only thing we will do, give me the sword. What is this? This is the sword. The Bible is the sword. That's what Jesus said, the word of God is the sword. That's what Paul wrote and he said, it is a sword that cuts to two sides. Am I talking to somebody? Anything that you need to know the truth about, don't go to anybody. Take the sword. Just take the sword. Ask the Bible, is this baby going to live or not? The Bible will tell you, the devil came to kill, to steal, and to destroy, but I came so that you may have life and have it in abundance. Akachukua mpanga akasema unajua mpanga watu wote ndio akasema mchukue kwanza yule mwenye amekufa usiku tuko huko bali wakapeleka mbali mulete kale kile kanaishi wakakaleta akasema usogeeshe hapa wakasogeesha akasema wewe unasema mtoto wako ndio kwani the fact that they saw you with my boyfriend, it does not mean he is your husband. I'm not talking to somebody. They saw you with my boyfriend, but you are an alcoholic. My boyfriend was with you, but my boyfriend will become my husband. I'm not talking to somebody. The fact that you are the one holding it, it is not yours, it is mine. Some of the people want to push it. Nikifika wakati wa ukweli, watagundua hii ni moto, siwezi beba hii. Unaachilia. Hello. Hello. Let me tell ladies and men who are here and you're believing God for a marriage. It is coming at the right time. Oh. I'm telling you, this girl, I looked for her with all means possible. more. But nothing was coming. The guys who were around her were powerful and mightier than me. Little I never knew they were taking care. Am I talking to somebody here? They were just taking care for me. When time came, she became hotter. They could no longer hold. Kwa sababu everybody else knew that she's hotter. It's only me who can carry. Yeah, are you glad you're the same with me? Nobody can carry me. How many hot? I can burn their hands. The Holy Spirit around me is fiery. Because I was preserved. May God release what is yours. I said, may God release what is yours. I said, may God release what is yours. I said, may God release what is yours. Anyone holding what belongs to you, may God burn. May they start burning in their hands. May they start burning in their hands. I said, may they start burning in their hands. Whatever they are holding, that is what they are. Na Mungu kwa magoti unasema baba hii harusi itapata siku gani? Watafungua macho na wanakutana ni makaa ya moto. Jesus. Jesus. He is my boss. May he release what you need. I said may he release what you need. I said may he release what you need. So they took the sword. They took the baby. Chukua mpanga. Inua juu. Akasema now, where? So lazima ni wako, nia! Na wewe, baba hako kiangalia kuwa ya mtoto. Na yangu. Baba wane kama, it is the same. I don't care. Upanga, utaamua. Wewe, shika yungu. Shika yungu. Kenyo tabeba, chako. Kenyo tabeba, chako. Aka kenye kalikoka mejoa umesha zika wake. Uwa! Kata! Nafikiri kota kakwana na leka. Kata! Kata! Kata usichelewe! Kata! Wakata matawabu sio wako. Anything that is yours will not be killed. I say anything that is yours will not be killed. I say whatever is yours will not be killed. I say whatever belongs to you will not be killed. Wakati tu aliinua hivi, that mother, the real mother, counted the costs, counted the 9 months of labor. And she remembered being an harlot. There was no husband to console her. There was nobody to take her to the clinic. There was nobody to walk with her. She went through the labor pain alone. She took that baby after birth. She looked at the baby and she was like, this is what I was looking for. The reward of my pain. And she said, it has costed me. I cannot let it die. I'm not talking to somebody. And she said, shrieking, the cost of this baby cannot allow that sword to pass on. That sword cannot pass on this baby because this baby is so costly. You rather give the baby to the other woman, but not to kill the baby. Why? Because it costed her. What cost you? You protect her. May God cost you to protect her. Everything in your life that has costed you and whatever has ever costed you will not be taken by your enemies. Whatever has ever costed you will not be taken by strangers. Whatever has ever costed you will not be eaten. I cannot watch the death of this costly thing. Give that baby to her.
Prayed.
am not moving from this mountain unless you bury that problem. On the 14th day, at 9 a.m., I received the call of that guy telling me that, Akson, you will never hear of that problem again. I told my wife, they are counting, there is another month remaining. Eat it. Going checking, there is another month remaining. Eat it. Because you fought for it. It costed him and it has paid him. I came to tell you today, dear God. I say again, dear God. This woman does not care whatever is here. She has given it to God. Is that true? Is that true?
Yes.
I can tell you this. If she will never testify before you on the same altar, come back to me and ask if I am a man of God. Do you hear me?
Yes.
Do you hear me?
Yes.
Today, I am giving you an opportunity in this week. Go and look for something costly and dare. If you will, say, I will. Go and look for something costly in your life. Something that when you just hear, he in a nigarim, and there, God. Take it to God. Hello? A woman came to me here last time, and that woman looked like she did not even have shoes. But do you know what she came to tell me? She came to tell me, Pastor, I am sick and tired of being the way I am. I have one land in Kahawa West, and the title deed is what I'm giving out. I told her, woman, have you confirmed with your heart? She said, I am a widow. I have nobody to consult, but I'm giving that land. I looked at her and I said, I will pray for you. God will answer your prayers. And because you have desired to give that title deed out, where do you go to church? She said, I go to church. She told me the place. I told her, if I take that title deed, you will receive your answers, but I will be a thief because I'm not your pastor. Take that title deed. And then I will pray for my God and he will testify. She came back and she said, Pastor, if you see me today, you cannot believe me. I gave my pastor the title deed, and everybody who never thought of helping me, even my family, they opened businesses, they have started thinking of me, everything has changed. Fear to take anything from your hands is because I shepherd you. I am your pastor. Do you hear me? Go and test God this week and come next week and see if God will not answer what you are looking for. Do you hear me? Go and put God to test. Give God what you have never given him before. Try him with what you have never tried him before. Rick Warren said, the day he decided to transform his life is the day he changed from tithing 10% and he started tithing 90%. Am I talking to somebody? Rick Warren, he does not tithe 10%. He tithe 90%. And right now, as we are talking, he's among the richest pastor we know. With the remaining 10% of what he gets. Do you know? You are talking of 10%. You know, she took us. You mean that I should have 10% because our salary is 51. And if you decide to test that God, he will give you. you want 10% that can shut our mouth. Do you hear me? I was asking you, do you know 10% of 1 billion is 100 million? Can't you survive with 100 million? Am I talking to somebody today? Can you go and taste God with something? Is there somebody who can wake up and say, in the course of this week, I will test God. I will bring something on this altar to test this God. Something costly to see if he will not pay back. And if God will not pay back, you are free to come back and say, please, mnirudishie. Nilipeanaga kitu fulani lakini, mambo pari yaende mzuri, yakaharibika. Because God is not at the top of man. I say, God is not at the top of man. Look at another neighbor. Test him today. And your life will change. Forever. In Jesus' name. Stand on your feet. Lift up your hands before God. Father, those hands are lifted up before you and not before a man. Accept them today. That whatever they will desire to test you with, you will pay them back. I pray that this word will not be stolen by the enemy. And they will not go and doubt your voice. I pray that you will take them into the dimension of testing you and see if you will not bless them. Say after me, dear Lord, I am ready to test you with something costly, and in return, it will pay me. I believe it will be a day of change for my destiny and for my life. I thank you for today you have spoken to me in Jesus' name. Celebrate the Lord. Thank your neighbor, tell your neighbor, if it will cost you, it will pay you. Neighbor, allow it to cost you, and it will pay you. Neighbor, I bless you. In Jesus' name. Surely, goodness and mercy shall follow you all the days of your life, and you shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. Amen. See you on Tuesday. Amen. See you on Tuesday at 6. The series continues. I said it's a series. Are we together? What? Cost you nothing? Good pay.